Hi, I'm Christine. In this video, I'll teach you how and when to use the conditional array function choose. This function is used when you have to select one option from an array, but also have a numerical index to help you with this selection. A common example where you'll see this is an interface that contains a wizard with steps. The choose function is similar to another popular function, abangMatch, but with one key difference. The match function allows you to make a selection based on a string value or a condition, while choose does the same based on an index. Like match, the choose function has an easy-to-grasp syntax and will make your conditional logic easy to read. Let's look at an example that uses this function. This interface from a meal delivery app contains a wizard with the numbered steps for entering the address, step 1, adding payment, step 2, and reviewing the order, step 3. The expectation is that once the user completes one step and clicks Next, her UI will change dynamically to display the next block of fields. In this UI, I can achieve this effect by implementing the choose function. Overall, step wizards are a perfect candidate to use this function, or you can use it in other scenarios when you have an index for the elements of the array. To define what blocks to display, I started by defining the key parameter. The key is the required one-based index, meaning it starts with 1, that defines what value from the array to return. For example, if I have an index consisting of 1 and 2, and the key is 1, choose will select the first option in the array. If it's 2, it will select the second option. In this example, my key is the rule input RIBangCheckoutView. It can equal 1, 2, or 3, and I implemented this index using a local variable in the parent interface. With the key parameter in place, this expression doesn't need anything else, but only the list of options to display. These are called choice parameters. In this UI, the options are the three different interfaces that I built for each step in the meal checkout process. As you can see, I added them into this expression using the domain prefix RuleBang. If you want to experiment with choose, try it out by implementing the milestone pattern. Once you create an interface, drag and drop this pattern to the live view, and then experiment with choose by adding different sample UIs to the wizard steps. Let's recap what we've learned so far. The choose function is used when you want to select a single value from an array of options using a numerical index. You're likely to encounter this function in UIs that contain wizards with numbered steps. This function has an easy-to-grasp syntax, and it will make your expressions cleaner and easier to understand and maintain. To learn more about this function, check out the Appian documentation. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.